How you doing? My name is George Weiner. I'm the chief whaler of Whole Whale, and I am talking about vague, sometimes ambiguous questions that you may ask a developer. We find ourselves in these conversations at times as leaders of nonprofits and social impact organizations where, oh my gosh, we need to build a website. We need to make a change. So I'm just going to go back and forth and cover this conversation from what you're thinking as somebody who needs to manage this project and what the developer is thinking when they get this type of question that is vague yet important. So the first question that we hear a lot is, how much does a website cost? And fundamentally is it's going to cost as much as you have. You will get what you pay for. It's totally possible to do a website for $100. You know, go to Squarespace, just pay them, click on buttons. But then you end up with templates or brochureware that may not communicate your brand. The website ranges in terms of cost that Whole Whale does our, you know, builds when we do them. We'll start at about 30K and go up from there. So when you're thinking about the cost, it's important to do and go through the RFP, the request for proposal process. Wholewhale.com/RFP will literally walk you through for free the questions you should answer in terms of functionality, in terms of the content, in terms of the brand and design elements that you need to create your website. You can easily get ripped off if you walk down the street saying, hey, I've got $250,000, can you make me a website? No one's gonna say no to that. As a strategy, I much prefer building for exactly what you need first and not blowing the bank thinking that once I build this tower, there's no maintenance whatsoever. It's not a single one and done cost. After you build this structure, it's gonna need the plumbing, the electric, the work done. It's not just gonna stand alone and just continue to produce for you, unless we're talking about it for sure. So it will cost what you have, balanced with what you need, and I've given you some ranges there. You can build at these different levels. How hard is it to change that thing on the website? Now, the funny thing about making changes on the websites is there is super easy and super hard depending on how flexible you are in terms of how that's executed. Most sites, say if you are in a WordPress site, have style sheets. So if you wanted to make a change, let's say to the color of the background or color of the nav, that is literally like one line of code that you can just change. Generally speaking, we're talking about an hour's worth of work in order to change a color or change something about the nav and move things around and organize. Those are controlled generally through WYSIWYGs, which you see is what you get, editors. So inside of WordPress, you can go in, click inside the menu, and suddenly move things around. So those types of changes, pretty easy. However, if you're starting to play around with the functionality of the site that's going on through every site, every page, then it can get a bit deeper. If you have to go into the what is called the back-end coding of how maybe forms are working, depends on how that's set up, that can be difficult because it deals with a database. You want to also consider if you are making aggressive changes to the layout of pages, how it's not just your desktop, but also it's going to appear on mobile. If you come in with a flexibility, hey, I'm trying to get from point A to point B for my users, and be a bit more flexible rather than saying it has to be done exactly this way, it must be 800 pixels wide, or I'll eat my hat. You can work with a developer in finding the most reasonable way of executing the edits on hard or easy to change in a website. How long will it take to do X or Y? You're gonna get a much more vague answer if you're not as specific. So again, I encourage you, even if you're just doing some updates, to really itemize it out. You can use a faceted feature list to say, here's all the functionality elements that I want done on my site, and then go through and say, all right, here's my business need, here's my user value for it from 1 to 5, and please, as you know, you can ask your developer, please give me a rating of 1 through 5, 1 being easy, 5 being hard, of how long you think this will get to take. You're doing two things. One, you're proving yourself the value of whether or not it's worth it to build the thing. And then also, you can maybe reprioritize based on how hard it is and also the value you're gonna give to the business or your users. In terms of estimation, anytime someone says, hey, you know, once we're getting over the couple hours fix and it's like, oh, that'll take me a few days. In your mind, a few days means, all right, I can get it by freaking Friday because I'm talking to you on Monday. In developer speak, it's could meaning like that many hours. So wait a minute, they're actually talking about 24 actual hours and they're doing 24 hours of in-depth focused coding over the course of a month. Clarify when you're talking about days in terms of number of hours to do the work or delivery dates. As a rule, in my opinion and in my experience, developers are not the best project managers. So I go back to the faceted feature list saying, hey, which features are we rolling out at which parts? How long will it take is generally best answered if you can itemize what you're trying to do. Again, the great tool, wholewhale.com/RFP. How long until Google indexes my site or I show up in search? The most common time you're asking this question is either when you have created a new site or relaunched your old site. In the case that you have relaunched your old site and you are starting to see a more than 3 month drop in traffic as Google re-indexes your pages. Ideally, it's before that you start to see that, all right, organic traffic, which means people typing in keywords that come to your site previously, start to rise back up again. Great, but if that's not happening after 3 months, something is very, very wrong. And you should do something like hire an SEO expert in order to come in and see like what's gone wrong. How long it's going to take to show up in Google search results is a tricky one, because it may never. You should start to see a bit of trickle into that page though over that course of anywhere from like 3 to 6 months, start to see a little bit more. But in general, if you've waited 6 months and you're still not there, you're definitely like nothing's coming for you, right? Train left the station. You just don't optimize for that keyword the way you should have. You can do searches on Incognito and see where you're landing. You can use certain tools like Moz or even Ahrefs to find where you're ranking on that page. It's also dependent on a number of SEO factors. Whole Whale has got an online course for content marketing and SEO, which goes, you know, hours into the topic. How long until this happens can be difficult. You should be at least monitoring and being able to answer your own questions by also using Google Search Console in conjunction with Google Analytics to tell the traffic that's coming into your page, to see which pages you're on. And frankly, if you're not on page one, that's where 90% of the traffic is going anyway from the click-through, or they refine the search. So that is the general answer. This has been Whole Whale TV talking about vague but important questions. Please send us a tweet at Whole Whale if you've got a weird sort of tech question that's come up and you want to see some translation on it. If you want to see more videos, voila, I'm not being vague at all. Quite specific, in fact. There's one right here.